Hello my friends, and welcome back to the channel. You're watching Project Dark Knight Horror, and I am your host, The Dark Knight. Today, we're going to be focusing on the world of urban exploring. We're going to take a trip into the hidden world of urbex. Urban exploring, or urbex for short, has been around for decades, but it's only since the birth of social media that exploded urbex into the forefront of Western society. Nowadays, it's easy to find videos on urban exploring everywhere. But every now and then, explorers come across things they wish they hadn't, like weapons, gangs, drugs, and even cadavers. The world of urbex is dangerous, and so the following videos you're about to see prove that. It's that time again, so close the door, shut the curtain and turn off the lights and go full screen as we get ready to watch horrifying videos that prove urban exploring can be bad for your health. Booby trap. 2 years ago, a video surfaced online from an unknown YouTube channel called Up Syndrome 1. The channel only has a small amount of subscribers, but this video has been viewed almost 3 million times. It's quite old now, so I'm hoping most of you wouldn't have seen it. In the video, a group of guys are exploring an abandoned house which was used as a meth house. In other words, it was used by drug addicts. In the video, the guys are about to ascend the stairs when one of them notices something out of the norm. Attached to the banister is a thin, almost invisible string or fishing line. The guys stop and follow the line up the wall with their eyes. When they see what the line is attached to, they are horrified. Watch.
Look,
the wire,
look.
Right, that goes up.
Look at the nail.
With a knife system.
Oh my god.
Dude, that'll
f***ing
kill somebody,
look
bro.
Look, what's in there? The knife. Right there. You see the wire?
You don't see the knife up there?
God. Right here, you see this wire going over here?
Yeah, that's f***ing.
It's going right through your heart.
It's on a f***ing crutch with a knife.
How'd you catch that?
I'm a bad motherfucker.
That. Yo, touch it. Let's see. Yo, cut it. You see that?
Look, come here, Scott.
You saw that, Scott? Come
Scott,
here.
Look at here. See this string?
Oh, no, don't f***ing move. That's a booby trap. See
Scott,
the
see
glass?
The string?
See, they put some the broken glass over here.
Look, you know, see so the, when... See this string?
Who's videotaping?
I am.
You ready?
I am. Hold on.
See the string?
With this,
yeah.
This.
Now look up. Come over here. Let Scott see before you hit.
Hold on.
Let him see. That's for real.
That's f***ing.
Like, why is this glass right here?
This is homicide.
It's homicide up here. Come here.
I see it, yep.
No, you don't see. Go to the other side.
No, I see it.
Look at this wall. Look at the knife.
It's on a fucking crutch, dude.
See the knife?
Oh, yeah.
Hold on, he's ready? Yeah. Who's videotaping? Amir, you videotaping this shit?
Yeah. Hold on.
I'm getting far away from this thing.
All right, Amir, you got it?
Yeah.
You send this ball.
I think you know where you trip it. Stop at the bottom of the step.
You think?
Yeah.
What is it?
At the step.
Oh!
Look at that fucking thing.
Yo, that fucking straight up killed you right in your fucking head, dude.
What's his house? This house ain't fucking up.
Look at that.
That is insane.
Yo, coming right to
Yo,
your
that
head.
He's got bodies.
Look at this. Look at this.
Yo, that's right in your fucking
no,
head.
No. Hold on. You need to stop more. You need to step off.
Yo, that would have got you right in your fucking neck.
Oh my god, right in his head.
There wasn't a follow up video after this, so I don't know if they went upstairs or if there was any more booby traps in the house. What I do know is, if that was me, I wouldn't have taken another step. The cadaver. 5 years ago, Yusuf from the YouTube channel Yusuf Ahmadi was looking for an interesting place to explore. His friends told him about an abandoned building that had satanic symbols that could be seen from the outside, so they decided to go and explore. With a quick jump over the wall, they were into the grounds. The building was quite large and the windows were all boarded up. They tried entering various windows and doors, but they were unsuccessful. It's only when they went round to the back of the building that they spotted an open window. As Yusuf draws closer, he spots blood. In fact, he spots a lot of blood. Suddenly, the mood changes from one of laughing and joking to danger. As he makes his way to the ladder, he follows the trail of blood, which goes right up into the open window. What he encounters next will stay with him for the rest of his life. Watch.
You can actually see everything. The roof can drop down, you know. Does places like this have asbestos? Don't climb that. Let's go around like that. The shit can drop on our heads. Fuck that. Come, keep going, man.
Hello, is anybody home?
It's the fucking... Alright. Keep going. Something jumps out of us right here after the fucking screen, bitch. Something could just run out right now. The whole thing's destroyed. I can hear that. Wait. It's a fucking room. Alright, don't go in there. Something might drop in your head. Maybe try bust one of these down. That's like too much clutter in there.
Do you see that face?
In the top. Fucking where?
In the top. I'm not even joking. I swear I saw a face. It's like busting out the plane right now.
I swear. Where is the six on the wall?
Oh. Hey, that's actually crazy.
It's insane. And a locked up shed in here as well. The shit doesn't open, don't try. What is in there? I see metal. It's like a shovel in there.
I see power tools. On a garage sale.
Do you hear that on my bugging out?
Put the key in the ignition as well.
Hey, did you hear that on my bugging out?
Yeah.
Sound like someone threw something from up there or some shit. I don't want to have another Westwood strap. Some crackheads out there, probably. Should we try and go in? That room has six nails locked in.
You've got to tell
me
the first.
Not telling me. Oh, is that blood?
Show me your cut on it.
Is that blood? Oh,
you changed.
Fuck that. Fuck that. Fuck that. Oh, my days. Oh, shit.
As he is faced with the horror, He runs away from the danger, but unknown to the explorers, they run straight into another body. So, were they casualties of drug gangs, or were they sacrifices for the occult? The two explorers phoned the police and the ambulance carried the cadavers away. To watch the full video and to check out more of his channel, jump over to Yusuf Ahmadi. Whispers in the Dark. Frank from the channel known as Exploring Abandoned Mines and Unusual Places is an avid urban explorer. In fact, he has explored hundreds of mines, buildings, and well, unusual places. But the video I'm going to show you is from 4 years ago, and it's amazing. So, in the video, Frank is testing a torch at the abandoned Waldeck mine located deep in a forested canyon. Everything was going well. The torch was working well and the journey through the mines had no hiccups. I must point out the video was filmed all in one with no cuts or breaks in the film. At the 12-minute mark, Frank passes some overhead wooden beams that hold up the tunnel when suddenly he hears something really weird.
And that's looking back at the ceiling and where we came from, which is that way. So, yeah, that's pretty cool. And I think the tunnel dead ends right down there. That's it. So, right here, there's one of those insulators for the wiring, knob and tube wiring. So let's head back out. Sometimes we can see stuff on the way out that we missed coming in because we were facing the wrong direction. But yeah, this is crazy. These timbers up there. That's really dangerous. So we'll get through here as fast as we can and get out of here before this all comes down. Here's that ore chute again. I gotta get past this chute. Wow. Crazy. And then you can see how big these timbers are. That's about almost a foot in diameter, the big cross timbers. So they had to put big ones in here to hold up all of this rock. And you can see right here where some of these boards are bending. Do you hear that? Sounds like, what is that, wind? I don't know if you can hear that on the camera. Do you hear that? It stopped. Well, I don't know what that is. That doesn't sound like wind, but that's crazy. Don't know if that's a bird or I don't know what that is. It almost sounds like snakes, but wow. I've heard some weird stuff in mines, but that is definitely creepy. I don't know what that is.
At first, he thinks it's the wind, so he carries on. But shortly thereafter, our intrepid explorer realizes something isn't right. Frank is suddenly surrounded by multiple disembodied whispers saying get out, amongst other things. It becomes abundantly clear to our intrepid explorer that he's not welcome. With that, Frank has had enough. Frank says his YouTube channel isn't about the paranormal and only about 1% is about ghostly activity. But that 1% of Frank's amazing collection is well worth watching. So, if you want to check out videos about abandoned mines and unusual places, or that 1% of creepy paranormal videos that Frank has filmed in the mines, check out his YouTube channel. I highly recommend it. Silent Assassin. For my next video, we're back with the popular YouTube channel Yusuf Ahmadi, and this time he's exploring an abandoned school which is known to be haunted. Screams are said to be heard, bangs and footsteps all across the school, but what Yusuf encounters that night wasn't paranormal. As the explorers are walking through the empty corridors, they stumble upon some used bullets. Among them, they find 9mm, 22 calibers, and most worryingly, a 12-gauge shotgun shell. After a few minutes, they hear what sounds like a scream, so they go to investigate. Suddenly, out of nowhere, in the dark corridor ahead of them, a silent figure can be seen walking from one door to the next without even acknowledging them. Yusuf tries to get a response, but after no replies, they get a fright of their life. Watch.
Doesn't look like he's been unscrewed or anything, just smashed open. Alright, he's going in first. Shall I go first? So another way in. Keep trying to run that way. So we go here. Guys, I don't know why the instrument's down. I don't know what this is supposed to be. Tape there again. Don't know why. It's probably the creepiest hallway I've ever come across. Just because of the sheer size. Like, it feels like it's never ending. Guys, you can see that these staircases haven't been in use just by the fact of how much spider webs there are. And there's some red tape here. I don't know why they would need red tape to go. Let's check out some of the rooms. Nothing else to see. There's more tape. So we're at the lumber room. Guys, this looks like a... Holy shit, that is a bullet. All my life, that is a bullet.
There's a bullet inside.
Guys, is that a bullet? Or am I imagining shit?
It looks like a bullet.
What does it say on it? 1 second. 556 1K11. Is this a bullet, guys?
Look, it looks like it's been shot.
Yeah, it's been shot somewhere.
Yep. Legit, there was an actual shootout. There's no way there wasn't.
That's been shot, look at it.
That says, let me read that. 5.56 1K11, what does that mean? It's like an extra bit, is this like a casing or something?
It's been dent, it's been shot.
Yeah, guys, this has been, like, the front has popped off. I don't know how bullets work exactly, but if someone knows anything about bullets, can you let me know if this is real? Yeah.
It looks a bit red. Can you see that?
Holy fucking shit, it does. Guys, the bullet is red. At the tip.
It's like lightly red. Like,
yeah, I don't know if that's like rust or that's gone into someone. The tip is red.
It could be blood.
I guess there's another room. It's fairly empty as well. Oh, wiring and shit.
Yo, Yusuf, what is this?
Guys, someone tell me if this is real ammo. Is that a bullet? It's got the front popped off. It says Elay 12. Is that a 12 gauge shotgun bullet?
Don't know. Why is that ammo here?
I don't know, guys. I think the red tape is legit. I think this is the second bullet we've seen in here. I
Because then there was like a real fucking pinning in here.
That explains the RIPs, whatever, yeah.
It says 12. I'm pretty sure that means that 12 gauge shotgun, maybe, I don't know. Maybe I'm talking out my ass, but I'm pretty sure. It says E-L-E-Y. I think, guys, there was a real killing in here. Guys, please tell me this is not a bullet as well. 9mm. It says 9mm. L-U-G-E-R. D-A-G. Guys, is this a bullet? I think we've seen, like, 3 bullets now. Like, what the fuck? I don't know what this is. Is this like a casing? What is this? Anyone knows anything about ammo, can you let me know? Alright guys, so these are all the bullets we found. There's like a 12 gauge shell there, I think. I'm pretty sure this is a 9mm bullet. I don't know what bullet this is. Maybe you lot can tell me. Hello? It's probably just an explorer, man. Hello? Are you an explorer? Just talk to him, he's not gonna fucking kill us.
He obviously does not want us here.
Hello?
I didn't
look at
his face.
Actually, don't go anymore.
As Yusuf calls out to the silent figure who's in the room just in front of them, they suddenly hear the unmistakable sound of a gunshot. To watch the full video and more crazy urban exploring videos and more from Yusuf Ahmadi, you know what to do. Murder scene. 5 years ago, Chris Condon and his mates explored an abandoned general hospital and found what he described as a murder scene. So 1 year after the initial visit, Chris decides to go back to the same location to see if the blood was still there, and this time to let the viewers see. Chris and his mates explore hundreds of locations and they never vandalize or remove anything from the place they are exploring, which is quite refreshing from someone so young. All they are concerned with is exploring. At about the 8-minute mark, at the top floor, they find what they've been looking for. Watch.
Right now we are looking, it's kind of facing up. We're looking for that murder scene that I found a long time ago, because I uploaded the video like a year ago. And we found all that blood on the table.
If I can't see, I'm concerned.
I don't know where it is, bro.
I've heard some sketchy shit.
I thought it was on the floor below us. I thought it was the second to top floor.
Y'all didn't even really that.
Slowly turned towards me.
You can shoot it. We found it, guys. Okay, I need you science people to tell me if this is real or not. Because I know blood, like, gets dark after a while, and it's definitely dark.
Not a good angle.
Looks like a throat was... Look at this. If you guys haven't seen that video, it has like 500,000 views, but it was copyrighted music. Like, it was a terrible video. Like, I used music over the entire thing. Are you trying to take a picture?
I was, yeah.
I wouldn't put your butt on that. You might touch it. It's disgusting.
That's what my goal was.
It was like a handprint, bro.
Where?
Right there.
You're welcome.
Ew. It looks real because it's black now, and blood turns black after a long time. It's been about a year.
Oh my god. My ISO's 400.
Yeah, I just don't want to touch anything.
Let me get back a little more.
It is a lot of blood.
I feel so bad.
People died in here. There's so much freaking blood.
I know blood is normal for a hospital, but why is it all over the walls and floor and even on the ceiling in some places? The video is quite long, so I couldn't fit as much as I wanted to. So, to check it out in all its full glory, the name of the channel is Chris Condon. Splatterhouse. This next short clip is quite shocking. a group of kids find an abandoned building and decide to explore. But what they are faced with is something straight out of a horror movie. The scene starts with no explanation and keep their voices to a whisper in case there's someone in the area. What is on the floor is very, very fresh and looks like it happened hours, maybe minutes ago. The kids quickly take some shots and film the scene. If you look carefully, you can even see the blood congealing as it hardens. Watch.
See the bullet on the ground over there? Oh my god. It's still wet. Looks like there's some red slime down there. I don't know about you, but that looks like it might be the culprit. Might be.
Shopping list. In the next video, Dan Bell is exploring a 1920s abandoned apartment complex. In the first part of the exploration, it goes as planned. The house is quiet and Dan keeps getting a feeling that someone has been using it. Halfway through, a dog can be heard coming closer as it barks, indicating this place is guarded. And Dan finds out why.
Is there anybody up here?
Dan comes across a green bag full of fresh shopping supplies and a plastic box that when he lifts it up, he can see is full of drugs. As he's leaving, a door slams and Dan hears people and dogs coming closer. He realizes he's in big trouble, so he turns off the lights and hides. He hides in the bathroom in the dark and tries to stay as quiet as he can, as angry voices and footsteps can be heard just outside. While in the bathroom, Dan is so scared and is pleading not to be caught. You can hear the fear in his voice as the people outside argue about money. I couldn't play what they were saying because of restriction rules, but As Dan hears the door slam, he decides to make a break for it. As he leaves, he passes the same green bag, and from the looks of it, the plastic box has gone. Dan, very quietly and very scared, runs off into the forest. The video has been deleted off YouTube since, for reasons only Dan Bell will know. It took a lot of digging to find it, and even that is only a bit. Dan Bell has made hundreds of videos about urban exploring, and a lot of them see Dan exploring shady, dangerous places that other urban explorers wouldn't go. If you're interested in urbex, I highly recommend watch This Is Dan Bell. Serial Killer's Hideout. Years ago, the YouTuber Mo Sarji and CJ Faison were starting to build a following, but they weren't as big as they are now, so things were a little bit different back then. In this video, they were exploring an abandoned chicken farm in Virginia, but this farm was rumored to be the hideout of serial killers Ray and Faye Copeland. Reports said this place was used to kill people and, apparently, they chopped them up and fed them to animals. I don't know how much of that is true. I am just telling you how it is. So, as the light fades, the two intrepid explorers start to check out the massive complex.
So the challenge for tonight is spend the night here, stay as long as we possibly can. We might even sleep here the night and explore this entire area and show you guys some really cool things. Hopefully we catch some haunted things on here. Hopefully we catch some ghosts, some demons, some serial killers maybe. I don't know, did they ever catch them?
They start the video by checking out the house that the Copelands lived in and show where they killed people. During the video, they hear bangs and door slam, but they just shake it off. Then they hear footsteps coming from upstairs.
Dude, don't shut up.
Oh shit, sorry.
Dude, you hear the shit out of me.
Just literally nothing here. You go left, I go this way. Okay? Look, guys. Literally nothing here. Yo.
What?
Nothing there?
No.
No animals?
No.
This is creepy, man. What's in here?
What the fuck?
I thought that was you.
No! Fuck this shit, dude. No.
It sounds like there's somebody upstairs. It literally sounds like there's somebody upstairs. What the hell's going on?
What?
Something just fucking walked by that fucking window thing. Window.
You for real?
Dude, what the hell is going on, dude?
Dude, it sounds like there's somebody upstairs.
Dude, I don't like this shit.
But it's only when they reach the large barn area on the first floor when someone makes themselves known. Watch.
Drugs in my eyes.
I hope it was, dude.
So, as you guys can see.
Be careful over here, man, for real.
Huh? The floor. I know, the floor is.
The floor is super soft this way.
Dude, look how cool this is. I've never been in a place like this before. This is kind of new for me. It's kind of cool.
I swear I just heard something. But...
look at. It's like somebody walking.
No, it just sounded like.
What the fuck?
I'll fucking kill you.
There's somebody here. Turn off your lights, turn off your lights.
Fucking jump.
Turn off your lights.
It's fucking
jump. Turn off your lights, turn off your lights.
It's fucking jump.
Shh, just stay still.
Dude,
there's somebody here.
Fuck.
What the fuck?
Dude, that was a real fucking person.
That's not a ghost, that's a person, bro. There's somebody here.
Turn your fucking light off.
But where you go, we gotta see. You wanna jump out the second story?
Yeah, dude. Alright, yeah, that's fucking...
that's high. Bro, we just gotta confront this guy. There is somebody here right now, dude. Just come. Bro.
Fuck that,
dude.
We
gotta confront
him. No! Dude, I'm fucking jumping.
Okay, I have an idea. I have an idea.
What idea is that?
I don't know.
No, seriously.
Bro!
Bro, the only way is to get down the stairs. If he's down there, we have to confront him. How else are we going to get out of here?
I don't fucking know. Jump.
Jump, he says. It's a high jump. Fuck it. Yo, there's a ledge here. We can climb down from here. I don't hear him anymore. Maybe he's... Do you think he's hiding? Sir, we don't mean you any harm. We're just explorers. Sir? We don't mean you any harm. We're just exploring. We're just making a video. We don't mean you any harm, but if you want to get tough with me, I'll get tough with you.
Bro, you need to shut the fuck up, dude.
No, fuck that. I ain't gonna let nobody intimidate me. I don't give a fuck who he is. Sorry for all the swearing, you guys, but...
Bro! Bro! Did they ever catch a serial killer?
I have no idea. Dude, please tell me they have.
I don't know.
Holy fuck, dude.
I don't know.
Dude, please. Did you read the article?
Yo, I'm telling you right now, bro. If you come up on me, no. you're not going to win this. I'm telling you right now. No, I don't care, bro. I'm not going to let nobody intimidate me. Let's just jump out of the windows.
Are we sure he's not outside?
Huh?
Are we sure he's not outside?
I don't know. He's quiet. I haven't heard from him in a while. I told him I'm gonna do something if he tries to roll up on us, and he just went quiet. Maybe he's scared of me.
Are you gonna jump too?
I don't know about that, because my foot still hurts from when I broke my toe.
Dude, I'm not taking the fucking stairs. I'm jumping.
Okay, you jump, I'll take the stairs. I'll confront him, I don't care. I'll knock the guy out.
Shh, shh, shh.
Yeah, make all the noise.
Here. I'm getting out of here, dude. Let's fucking meet up somewhere.
Okay. Just be careful. Just jump, bro. You're not that far off anymore. CJ's literally on the door. There you go. Hurry. Dude, hurry. Jump, 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 jump. There you go. Slide your butt down on it. Just don't get caught in it when you jump. Just left me? Is this guy for real? He literally just left me. What the fuck? Can I use this as a weapon? So, CJ, my boy, literally just took off running and left me. Wow. Okay, here goes nothing. Yo, you don't scare me, buddy. There's nobody here.
So, I did some digging, and it turns out that Ray and his wife, Faye Della Copeland, were sentenced to death in 1991 for the murder of 12 victims, but the police haven't found all the bodies, and still, to this day, they are still searching. Satanic Panic. If you're into urban exploring, you will know all about our next YouTuber. It's Exploring with Josh. In this video, he's in an abandoned school, which was used for the mentally disabled. The school was shut down in 2002 because of the lack of funding. The children were moved on, and the staff lost their jobs, and the building sat abandoned for decades. Now, the building is an empty shell which still houses desks and chalkboards which used to be the children's classroom. It's sad to see a school which was made for children with mental disabilities fall into ruin, all because of money. So, the video is of Josh and his mates exploring this sad school that once upon a time was a place of learning and hopefully happiness. But then, the friends make a gruesome discovery. In the far side of the school, in the boiler room, they smell something really bad and descend the stairs. This is what they find.
Alright guys, so right now we are heading on to our next building. What do you smell? Is there something you smell?
This whole building just smells disgusting.
Oh, well, I smell it now. This is awful. Oh, damn. You guys could go up first.
I'm going down.
Oh shit. What the hell?
Yo.
This is serious.
Guys, this is, I never seen like this.
This smells nasty.
What the hell? And it's still wet,
this is
guys.
Fresh.
This is fresh. Blood.
It's not blood. I don't know what it is.
It smells nasty.
Let's touch it, man.
Look at the duct tape.
Dude, that is insane.
Dude, this is insane.
Let's keep this shit. What the fuck?
What the fuck?
No, let's keep that duct tape. I want to touch any of this, yo. I'm gonna take it.
Dude, you're gonna get a bowl.
Dude, I'm getting a nice picture.
Hey, so Mike, can you aim your, let's all aim our lights at as we each get a picture.
Alright, I don't
wanna
touch it, but
I wanna touch it. Look at
the
tape on the arms.
Here, stand there, aim your light right there, Junior, please. Just stand at that point. I'm gonna take a few pictures.
Wait, you can see the candle marks right there. There's still wax on the floor. You see the wax?
I see the devil.
Dude, what
this
the fuck?
If you're a ghost hunter or you've spotted something amazing, send it in to Project Dark Knight Horror. The email is in the description. You never know, you might just see it on Project Dark Knight Horror. Tim, John and Ben. For my last video, we're going back in time to a video that gave me goosebumps the first time I ever saw it. And even till today, it holds mystery as to what exactly happened in that basement. Friends Tim, John and Ben go to an abandoned house to see if they can capture any paranormal activity. Rumors at that time were the house was used for satanic rituals, which is why the guys decided to check it out. The video is about 10 minutes long and I advise you to watch it all. The friends get to the house and explore it. Everything goes fine, as you would expect an exploring video to go. Remember, this was filmed 10 years ago, so the footage isn't the greatest of quality. It's when they get to the basement stairs, things start to get very, very wrong. Watch.
Okay, well, whoever's in here is crazy. Dude, look at this stuff. Who writes that?
Go to the door, guys. John, come here.
I'll do it.
Knock, knock.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, let's keep moving on. Let's go.
Whoa, this room is messed up.
Ah!
What? Oh! What? Where's John?
John. John. John, come on, man.
Dude, come on! I'll relax, you guys are so tight.
John, grow up, dude.
Dude, you're always like, come on. Dude. Hey, have a little fun.
I know.
Dude, just... dude, seriously, cut it out, alright?
Guys, just be quiet, it's fine. Just... alright, let's keep moving.
It's not like everything in here
just,
is in
no, room just, anyway. Just be quiet.
Dude.
Just stop talking.
Just have Mr. Juicy go first.
Fine, I'm gonna go first the whole time. You guys are just scared.
Well, it is a little bit creepy, isn't it?
Shh. You guys be quiet.
Dude, that's nasty. Oh my gosh, dude. Hey, come look at this. Come on, we gotta go down there.
Okay.
You guys wanna go?
You're going first. Whoa. Then. Okay. Just go. John, you wanna go?
Yeah, I'll go.
Dude, that's terrible. Dude, that smell is so bad. What? What? What is that? John, what is that?
It's like... Dude, come on, let's go. Let's check this out.
Mike, dude, that smells really bad.
It's like...
Oh. Guys, this smell is terrible. I think I'm gonna throw up. Guys, we need to go. I gotta puke.
Can check this out.
I'll hold back on that beer tank. Whoa.
Dude, are you okay?
Hey, God.
Dude, look at those hands, man.
The dollar's big, bro.
Hey.
Yeah, guys, we gotta go, man. We gotta go.
Whoa.
Do you hear that?
Oh my God!
Go, go, go! Go, 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 go! Oh my God! Oh my God! Oh my God. Oh. Oh, please, Robert. Okay, you gotta go. The door's locked!
Get open!
There's scratches! Go, go, go!
Help! Help!
What's happening? What
get off!
What's going on? Hang on. What's... John?
Help! Get off the
guy!
Get off!
What? Dude, come on. Okay. Did you hear that?
Fuck!
Oh my God! Oh, shit!
I have no idea
what we're
going.
Who is it? Who is it? John.
Go!
No. Where are we? Guys, I'm sorry.
It's fine.
John.
Let's go home.
John.
Let's go home. Leave me alone.
Dude, shut the camera off!
If you've made it this far, then I salute you. You are a true fan of horror. So, if you're interested in ghosts, poltergeists and demons, animal attacks, torture methods and Randonautica, cursed objects, true crime and dark mysteries, then Project Dark Knight is the channel for you. I try to bring you horror that's real, unedited and unrestricted, but sometimes the powers that be don't allow it. In the land of YouTube, the like button is king, so I implore you to hit the like button for me and subscribe to the project. History shows that people listen to large groups, so if Project Dark Knight gets more subscribers, then maybe we will be free to download and view horror as we see fit, and not what is regulated. We live in a world that boasts free speech, so I won't stop until I see that on YouTube. Thank you for watching. You've been watching Project Dark Knight Horror, and I am the Dark Knight, signing off. Peace!
Don't ever laugh as the hearse goes by, for you may be the next to die. They wrap you up in a big white sheet, from your head down to your feet. They put you in a big black box and cover you up with dirt and rocks.